Unit 14, Preparation of Final Accounts. Trial Balance. The trial balance is a statement of ledger account balances as on a particular instance. The trial balance is prepared to check or ensure the arithmetical accuracy of accounting. Preparation of trial balance is not an act that forms a part of the activities involved in the regular accounting cycle. Final accounting can be completed without the preparation of trial balance also. The trial balance is generally prepared at a time when all the ledger accounts are balanced, like at the end of the accounting period. Theoretically, the trial balance can be prepared as and when needed. In this mechanized or computerized accounting systems, trial balance is a statement that can be automatically derived as and when needed. Next topic. Adjustment entries. There might be a number of accounting transactions which might not have been taken into consideration by the time the trial balance has been prepared. Some of the reasons for the presence of such transactions are: 1. Transactions which do not occur in the normal course of business. 2. Transactions which have to be recorded only towards the end. 3. Transactions relating to error rectifications. 4. Accounting for the transactions. Explaining the points in detail. 1. Transactions which do not occur in the normal course of business. There are a number of transactions relating to the business which do not occur in the normal course of business. These transactions, unless deliberately recorded, do not get into the books of accounts. Examples for such transactions: 1. Stock taken away by the proprietor for personal use. 2. Abnormal loss of stock. Point number 2. Transactions which have to be recorded only towards the end. There are a number of transactions relating to the business which have to be recorded only at the end of accounting period. If the trial balance has been prepared before all such transactions into consideration have been taken into consideration, then they stay unrecorded in the books of accounts. Depreciation on assets. Expenses equal outstanding divided by prepaid. Incomes equal outstanding divided by pre-received. Point number 3. Transactions relating to error rectifications. The agreement of a trial balance is not a conclusive proof of absence of errors in accounting. Even in case where the trial balance agrees, there may still be errors existing in the books of accounts. These errors, if identified subsequent to the preparation of trial balance, need to be rectified, which needs journal entries to be passed for rectification. The transactions which have not yet been journalized, appended to the trial balance, are what we call adjustments. Thus, we can say that adjustments are transactions relating to business which have not been journalized by the end of accounting period. Since adjustments are also transactions relating to the business, we need to bring them into the accounting books by journalizing them. Point number 4. Accounting for the transactions. Recording the transactions represented by adjustments normally would result in existing balance in the affected ledger accounts to either increase or decrease. Transaction. Wages to the extent of rupees 43,000 are incorrectly recorded as salaries. This represents an error of principle whereby an expenditure that was to be debited in a particular account has been debited to another account. To bring the effect of this transaction into books, the journal entry to rectify this error has to be recorded. Next topic, effect of the transaction. The effect of the journal entry to be recorded in the above case can be analyzed as, in bracket, negative or minus. From salaries on the debit side of profits loss account, that is P/L. The salaries account, which already has a debit balance, is credited, which will result in a decrease in the existing debit balance. To bring the effect of this transaction, the amount involved in the transaction, ₹43,000, is deducted from the salaries account balance, ₹1,53,000, shown on the debit side of the profit loss account. In brackets, positive or plus to the wages on the debit side of trading account. The wages account, which already has a debit balance, is debited, resulting in an increase in the existing debit balance. To bring the effect of this transaction, the amount involved in the transaction, ₹43,000, is added to the wages account balance, ₹18,000, shown on the debit side of the trading account. These are the adjustments to be made to bring the effect of the above transaction into the books of accounts. Next topic, trading account. Trading account is a part of final accounts prepared by a business firm which shows gross profitability of business activities during a particular period. In other words, trading account shows total sales, total purchases, and all direct expenses relating to purchase and sales. Trading account is prepared by manufacturing companies and trading companies only because the sales and purchases of goods are done in these type of business firms only. Trading account is like a statement which is divided into two parts, that is income part and expenditure part. In income part, we show the following details. 1. Sales of goods less sales returns. 2. Closing stock of goods. In expenditure part, we show the following accounts. 1. Opening stock of goods. 2. Purchases of goods less purchase returns. 3. All direct expenses relating to purchase, sale and manufacturing of goods, like cartage and freight expenses, rent for godown or factory, electricity and power expenses, wages of workers and supervisors, packing expenses, etc. Next topic, profit and loss account. Profit and loss account is part of final accounts prepared by a business firm to know the net profit of the business activities during a particular period. Profit and loss account is different from trading account because trading account shows only the gross profit, while profit and loss account shows net earnings of the business firm. In profit and loss account, all indirect expenses and indirect incomes are shown. Profit and loss account is prepared with the help of trial balance. Profit and loss account is just like trading account, which is divided into two parts, that is income part and expenditure part. In income part, we show the following accounts. 1. Gross profit brought forward. 2. Indirect income, that is interest received, commission received, rent received, etc. In other words, indirect income means which is not directly related to purchase or sales. In expenditure part, we show the following details. 1. Gross loss brought forward. 2. All indirect expenses, that is any expenses which are not related to purchase and sales. Next topic, balance sheet. Balance sheet is part of loss account final accounts prepared by a business firm to know its financial position on a particular date for a particular period. Balance sheet shows the total liabilities and total assets of a business firm on a particular date. Balance sheet can be prepared on monthly basis or quarterly basis or half yearly basis or yearly basis according to its requirement. For example, all the companies registered with stock exchanges furnish monthly details relating to sales, profits, liabilities, and assets of listed companies. Therefore, these companies have to prepare the trading account, profit and loss account, and balance sheet on monthly basis. But if we talk in general, Then it is prepared at the end of the financial year. Balance sheet is prepared with the help of trial balance. Balance sheet is divided into two parts, that is, liabilities and assets. In liabilities, we show the following details. 1. Capital. 2. Secured loans. 3. Unsecured loans. 4. Current liabilities and provisions. 5. Profit and loss account. In brackets, balance of profit. In assets, we show the following accounts. 1. Fixed assets. 2. Investments. 3. Current assets, loans and advances. 4. Miscellaneous expenditure. 5. Profit and loss account. In brackets, balance of losses.